Welcome, music lovers, to Big Sandy's Eclectic American Countdown Show.
Let's start right here with a group from Washington, D.C., who came together while in high school in 1946. They synthesized the earlier vocal group harmony traditions with the newly rising rhythm and blues sounds. But they really hit their stride in the 50s on the Atlantic record label. They had hit after hit. Here are the Clovers.
A little mama, I took your loving, but it wasn't true to you. A little mama, I took your loving, but it wasn't true to you. Now you're leaving, little mama, I can't blame you if you do. Little mama, I lied.
Yes, I lied.
Big hit recordings around the country right now is a song called The Great Pretender,
We have with us tonight the group that made the song the hit it is. And here they are now, the Platters.
Oh, yes, I'm the great pretender. Pretending that I'm doing well. My need is such, I pretend too much. I'm lonely, but no one can tell. Oh, yes, I'm the great pretender. Adrift in a world of my own, I play the game, but to my real shame, you've left me. I'm the great pretender, just laughing and gay like a clown. I seem to be, but I'm not. You see, I'm wearing my heart like a crown, pretending that you're still around. I'm the great pretender, just laughing and gay like a clown. I seem to be what I'm not. You see, I'm wearing my heart like a crown, pretending that you're still around.
Still around.
From Los Angeles, California, one of the truly classic groups of the genre, the Platters. The Platters started out on the Federal label, and then after a couple of lineup changes, they went on to have some of the biggest hits of the 50s, led by Tony Williams, who you heard right there. When I was a teenager, I was so fortunate I had a chance to see the Platters at the Anaheim Convention Center, and hearing that man's voice, the guy right there, Tony Williams, hearing that voice fill the hall was one of the thrills of my young lifetime, the Platters. And now, let's check out a couple of scenes from an obscure British film called Sweet Beat, which was later released here in the United States under the name The Amorous Sex, with added scenes of strippers and one topless scene. No such thing here, unfortunately. But better yet, we have, right now, the Mellow Kings and the Five Satins.
You like this place, Bonnie. The food and wine are excellent. And as for the show, You'll see for yourself.
I'll love you forever as I love you.
And now, some very rare doo-wop footage. This just surfaced a few short weeks ago. Not many have seen it yet. The name of this group, and of any of the members of the group, Lost to Time. I have a feeling that maybe over the next few weeks, some more details will emerge. But for now, an Eclectic American Roots exclusive. I do know that... these guys were most likely students of Paxson High School in Jacksonville, Florida. Let's just sit back and take a look now. Enjoy it.
Well, I wonder, ooby-doo-hoo, who wrote the Book of Love?
Tell me, oh, who wrote the Book of Love? I want to know the answer. Someone from above.
Well, I wonder, who wrote the Book of Love?
I love you, darling, baby, you know I do. But I've got to see this Book of Love, find out why it's true.
Well, I wonder, who wrote the Book of Love? Chapter 1 says you love her, you love her with all your heart. Chapter 2, you tell her, you never go apart. In Chapter 3, remember the meaning of romance. In Chapter 4, you break up, but you give it just one more chance. Well, I wonder, ooby-doo-hoo, who wrote the Book of Love?
Tell me, oh, who wrote the Book of Love? I want to know the answer. Why did someone from above?
Well, I wonder, ooby-doo-hoo, who wrote the Book of Love?
Okay. When I come back, I have some really rare footage that I'm really excited to share. So I'll see you in a bit.
Big Sandy's Eclectic American Countdown Show.
In just a moment, we're going to take a special look at the pride of Fort Fairfield, Maine. Easy for you to say. Dick Curless. But first, the returning champion of honky tonk. And this one goes out to you, Mr. Lopez, the great Ray Price.
Now here's the Cherokee cowboy, Ray Price, to sing your great song called Heart Over Mind.
I love you so much that I can't leave you. Even though my mind tells me I should. But when you come back and tell me you still love me, all my thoughts of leaving do no good. You got me heart over mind, worried all the time, knowing you will always be the same. You'll keep hurting me, I know, but I still can't let you go, 'cause my heart won't let my love for you change. Friends tell me they see you out with others, and in my heart I try hard to forget. When you come back still hope there's some chance for us yet. You got me heart over mind, worried all the time, knowing you will always be the same. You'll keep hurting me, I know, but I still can't let you go, 'cause my heart won't let my love for you change. All you big and burly men who roll the trucks along, better listen, you'll be thankful when you hear my song. You have really got it made if you're all any place on earth but those Gainesville woods. It's a stretch of road up north in Maine that's never, ever, ever seen a smile. If they buried all the truckers lost in them woods, there'd be a tombstone every mile. Count them all, there'd be a tombstone
give one up your wine. Woman, start to thinking and I've given up the old wine. Woman and song.
The honky tonk girl herself, and the honky tonk hero of many, Loretta Lynn, still one of the greats.
Big Sandy's Eclectic American Countdown Show.
Hello out there, Roots music fans. On this episode of Eclectic American Roots, you'll see how our weekly matinee shows cover the heartbeat of the international roots music world. You'll be seeing a lot of cool clips from past shows, and we'll give you a broad taste of what you may have missed since the damn panic started. It's also a great time for you to help expand our audience. Share this retrospective with your like-minded friends. Now, let's meet our host. For over 40 years, Jim Washburn has written about roots music for the LA Times, the Orange County Register, and the OC Weekly. He's also written numerous books on the topic, including two beauties about Martin guitars. Jim has curated musical museum displays, such as one that he called Rhinestones and Twangin' Tones. It showcased many vintage country artists, spotlighting their nudie suits and pairing them with their personal guitars. It was cool. He published a book on that one, too. To discuss the music, lifestyle, and legacy of the Eclectic American Roots series, we welcome today's host, Jim Washburn.
Hi, everybody. We're here to let everybody know a little bit more about Eclectic American Roots, which is a great panoply of American roots rock right when we need it most. The nature of this music is that basically it springs from people's hearts to other people's hearts, and it's just across-the-board music that starts pretty much the way that Johnny Cash dunk did. It's basically people taking what life gave them and slapping out a happy rhythm with whatever life handed them to reach other people. And that's basically whatever the style is here, whether it's Tex-Mex, R&B, rockabilly, country, whatever it is, that's pretty much the root of it all. Every Sunday at noon Pacific time, I hope you guys check out the show we're about to talk about, which is Eclectic American Roots. He's been touring internationally with his Flyright boys for over 40 years now, and has become renowned on this show for the cool clips he provides every show as our video host. So please, if you would, welcome Big Sandy.
Big Sandy is a fixture as the MC at Viva Las Vegas, and we are proud that he is also a regular host of our Eclectic American Roots series. He's such a talented performer and so well-liked that he's always in big demand by many other artists, from Los Straitjackets to Reverend Horton Heat. Let's first take a look at Big Sandy performing the R&B song Lock My Heart with the Candles at the Screamin' Festival in Calella, Spain in 2014.
And then the man whose name is at the top of this thing every week, Christopher Burkhart, who since the 70s has been an evangelist for roots music from his early Western swing shows in Kalamazoo, that's in Michigan, home of Gibson guitars, to the more recent Southern California concerts as stellar shows. He loves all kinds of root music and has found a new career since the pandemic started, producing dozens of two-hour e-broadcasts with Tim Ellis of Campus JAX, called, as we mentioned before, Eclectic American Roots. So I guess, can you fellows, and take turns, tell me what, Christopher, since this is sort of in your ballpark, what led to this show?
We like creating these variety broadcasts. It's so much fun to get all these different personalities and talents together. And rather than make a show about a particular artist, like you see a lot on the internet, our show is all about artists all over the world making music the old-fashioned way. We call it American Roots, but we've had viewers and participants from everywhere, Spain, Australia, England, Portugal, and in most of the 50 states.
Mm-hmm. So I guess, can you fellows, and take turns, tell me what, Christopher, since this is sort of in your ballpark, what led to this show?
We like creating these variety broadcasts. It's so much fun to get all these different personalities and talents together. And we have a great production manager that knows how to string them together into a beautifully produced show. And rather than make a show about a particular artist, like you see a lot on the internet, our show is all about artists all over the world making music the old-fashioned way. We call it American Roots, but we've had viewers and participants from everywhere, Spain, Australia, England, Portugal, and in most of the 50 states.
Mm-hmm. Did this show somewhat grow out of frustration? Because, you know, you're so used to presenting shows and seeing people respond to them and dance and get excited about the music, and then all that shut down, and you're left with a room full of boots.
So one band we haven't had on the show, Room Full of Boots.
Yeah, so was it a sense of frustration as well that you're so used to being able to keep people happy and entertained, and that kind of dried up because of the pandemic?
Well, for me, I can say that it didn't grow out of frustration, but the show came along at a time where I would have started to get frustrated. The timing was really perfect for me. We had just found out that things were closing down. There weren't going to be any more live shows. Mm-hmm. Right about the time Christopher started coming up with the idea for the show. And I think initially I might have been one of a stable of a local artist that he had planned to draw from. Mm-hmm. As time went on, I became more and more involved, and it became a thing that I started to realize pretty quickly that I really needed. So we end up feeling like, you know, you want to feel like you're doing a service for other people who are, out of work, other musicians out of work, and other people who found themselves suddenly at home. It was entertainment for those people. I found that I was getting just as much, if not more, out of it myself. So it worked out beautifully.
Yeah. The pandemic left a big hole in all of our lives, and between Campus JAX, who's a pioneer in the concept of streaming weekly shows like this, and done very professionally. And we feel it's our mission to campaign for the guests on our shows by exposing their great talents to the audience. And in return, we have a tip jar where they earn donations and we share among the musicians on a show. It's a two-way street. You know, the musicians play, the audience pays, just like normal times.
Along with the rhythm of the music, there's also a certain rhythm to just presenting music. And you had such a groove going for so many years, you know, where, you know, hardships hit many forms, and some venues died and went away. You moved to other places, but managed to keep it going. And is this just a way to kind of keep the rhythm going until you can merge back into live shows?
None of this would be happening without Campus JAX in Newport Beach. Yeah. They not only have professional production work on these streaming shows they do, but they have built a beautiful outdoor hard covered canopy with a stage, multi-camera setup, and they've really become the pioneers in how to put on the best sort of live streaming show.
The production values that go into the live performances at Campus JAX certainly carry over into the video production as well. I'm just wondering, you guys make it seem effortless, and just from sitting here with you, I gather it isn't. Can you give us a little bit about what goes into putting every show together?
Well, a lot of it depends on getting the right people. You know, we've had hosts on the show over the last 11 months, including Deke Dickerson, Dave Stuckey, Eddie Clendenning. We've had Ronnie Mack, Kid Ramos, Rodney Dillard, Dave Stamey, and even Big Sandy hosting a couple of his own shows. Those are usually the ones that have a ladies in the title. Ladies of rockabilly, women of western swing, ladies of rhythm and blues. You'll find Big Sandy hosting those.
The amount of time I put into it has increased from episode to episode. The more I dig, the more I'm enjoying it, and the better I want it to be. So, you know, there's a you know, just a wealth of beautiful of treasures on the internet, but also I've dug some clips out from old VHS recordings off of the TV. People have sent me stuff since we've been doing this. People, it's been a great thing for me because people have been, hey, have you seen this clip? I said, no, I haven't. Or I'll stumble across something that nobody has seen before or very few people have seen before. So I'm learning so much as I go along, but it is so many hours each week that go into this. So as a cliche sort of thing to say, it's a labor of love, but it really has become that for all of us who work on the show.
Mm-hmm. That's good. It gives the live performers something kind of a benchmark to live up to as well.
Well, I think it's an addition to that. It's almost like the like if you're watching the DVD, like these are the extras that come along with it. So, you know, with Campus JAX, they do the live shows. Well, this is a supplement to that. I feel that's how I'm starting to look at it.
Yeah. Okay.
And we've managed to get some great guests between Big Sandy and myself. We've brought in people like Dave Alvin and Dale Watson, Jesse Baton and Chuck Mead. John McEwen, Rod Piazza, James Harmon, Rosie Flores. We've got a pretty nice track record of getting people involved with our show.
Yeah, there's a Grammy winner or two in there.
Big Sandy is a main attraction here at Eclectic American Roots. Here's a sample of his deep cuts from vintage videos.
It's your old pal Big Sandy here. Big Sandy here. Big Sandy. All right, Big Sandy here, and I'm delighted to be back again as your video host. Let's get to it now, friends, with an act that would be welcome at any picking party. Of course, I'm talking about Bob Wills and the Texas Playboys, this time with brother Billy Jack Wills on the vocals. Take it away.
I come home in the evening and I'm all tired out. See that bed, it makes me want to shout. Well, I lay down with a great big sigh. That's when the baby begins to cry. I got to rock-a-bye, baby, rock-a-bye, baby blue.
And now, some very rare doo-wop footage. There are the Cadillacs on stage at the Brooklyn Paramount. Look at that. He's losing it. And she's feeling it. The slick moves. Beautiful vocals. Cadillacs.
Man, I just love that clip.
I'll be back in just a little bit.
Don't go away.
Now, when you sit down every week, Christopher, what's your hope that the 2 hours ends up being? What you head into something and you hope it has an effect on people. What are you hoping to do with this?
When we first started doing the Eclectic American Roots series, we didn't think the pandemic was going to last more than a couple of months. So we thought we'd put some shows together and have some fun. Well, it became our mission. And now I feel like a Roots evangelist. There are so many different types of Roots to pull from, and we are trying to hit them all. I mean, honky tonk, Western swing, vintage country shows. We started out doing a show on Sun Records, another one on the old Town Hall Party. We evolved into the Ranch House Pickin' Party, the Hillbilly Fever shows. That whole Americana genre has been very popular. But Roots also includes rockabilly. And that's like the Viva Las Vegas Rockabilly Retrospective. We did a whole show about that. and the Ladies of Rockabilly, and of course the doo-wop show.
I was thinking about this earlier in the week. When I was a kid, as you mentioned, I grew up in Orange County. I went to Taft Elementary School. After school, each day in elementary school, I'd walk to the Taft Branch Library, and I would be digging through the albums. I would sit for hours with the headphones on, listening to all the different kinds of music that we touch on in this show. You know, blues, rhythm and blues, doo-wop, country, all of it. I spent hours there, and I would look for any books I could find on music history. I was just thirsty for it. And I'm hoping that this show can be for someone else what that library was to me.
Do you get the sort of satisfaction from this you do from the live shows at all?
I can say that I don't get the same satisfaction, but it's a different new satisfaction that I'm really enjoying. The way people engage with each other in the comments as the shows are being live streamed has sort of developed a family that has been following the show and a family that keeps growing. We try to engage with them ourselves, you know, in the comments as it's happening in real time. And some of those people, you know, have sent private messages to let us know how much they appreciate what we're doing. So it's different than hearing the immediate, getting that immediate feeling of people clapping and that visceral feeling when you're doing a live show. It's different, but it's great as well. It's new, different, and I love it.
Yeah, we have the ability every week to reach out to a whole different genre of people. Like if we do a show called Satchmo and Beyond, we're reaching a jazz audience that's pretty sincere about their likes and dislikes, but we also carry our Roots audience along with that. When we do shows like Graham Parsons Retrospective, again, that's a whole different classic rock kind of a group, but it's all under Roots and people are digging what we're laying down.
Hey there, it's your old buddy Deke Dickerson here, and I'm just here to put in a good word for the Eclectic American Roots series and Mr. Chris Burkhart for putting these shows on. You know, this last year during the pandemic, these online shows have been so important just to, you know, entertain us and keep the juices flowing and keep us thinking about music while all this other crazy stuff has been happening. So things like the Eclectic American Roots series shows have been super important to me, and I hope that you out there appreciate just how lucky you are for getting to have this feast for the eyes and the ears. So a big thanks to Mr. Burkhart, and big thanks for the Eclectic American Roots series. And let's keep it going. It's been a great thing, and I love it.
Here's a cut from his new innovative trio that plays plenty of good old hillbilly music, Deke Dickerson and the Whippersnappers, from a recent live show at Campus JAX in Newport Beach.
Too hot to handle, I know it's no use. Like a hot potato, I'm turning you loose. Well, I'm just a country boy, and it's plain to see you're too hot to handle for me. You walk down the sidewalk and you think you're so hot. You think you've got something that you haven't got. Well, I don't mind high hog eating if I ain't the hog. I don't mind some dogging if I ain't the dog.
Let's meet today's host, Viva Las Vegas founder and producer, Tom Ingram.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
Right now, we have the women of rhythm and blues with Dick Sandy and Abby Girl. Enjoy. If you know Eddie, you know he works hard spreading the gospel of genuine American rock and roll. Welcome, Eddie.
Hey there, everybody. How y'all doing? My name's Eddie Clendenning. Welcome to Stellar Shows at JAX, Eclectic American Roots.
You know, when you talk about American roots music, the blues is one of its cornerstones. Our co-host today has been in the SoCal blues scene since 1989. Scott Abeda of Rip Cat Records. I'm proud to welcome as one of our hosts today, one of my friends and guitar heroes, Kid Ramos. Hey everybody, it's time to meet our host today, the band leader of the Grammy Award-winning Los Tex-Maniacs, prominent purveyors of the true folklorico Tex-Mex sound. Today, Los Tex-Maniacs includes Max's nephew, Josh Baca, on accordion. He's a protege of Flaco and helps continue Max's stated goal, to do hip music that everybody in the world can relate to with the traditional conjunto elements, without losing the cultural touchstone of true Tex-Mex. Ladies and gentlemen, San Antonio's Max Baca.
Thank you, Christopher. Thanks so much, man. I'm very honored to be here.
Welcome back, everybody, to Christopher Burkhart's Eclectic American Roots Music Show. And Christopher's been promoting all forms of what we call traditional American roots music. Now the modern term is Americana. Honky-tonk music, Western swing, bluegrass, rockabilly, Tex-Mex, traditional blues, rhythm and blues, doo-wop, whatever the big mainstream commercial radio stations and big record companies say is not commercial or is not mainstream or there's not enough of a market for it, that's what this show is all about. We promote that.
Hey everybody, it's your pal Abby Girl here of Abby Girl and the Real Deal, and I just wanted to express how honored and what a joy it was to host the R&B episode of Eclectic American Roots, where I got to interview my R&B sisters and pay tribute to Ruth Brown. I want to thank Christopher and Tim and Big Sandy for all of the hard work that they put in on the show and for making my Sunday afternoons so much fun with all of the great episodes. I hope the show just keeps rolling along.
Today, our video host, music historian Big Sandy, and special musical guests like Dave Alvin, Jesse Dayton, and Deke Dickerson are going to share their honky-tonk heroes with you.
And now, a hero of many, certainly of mine, a champion of American music, I'd like to throw it to Dave Alvin.
Hey Robert, it's your old pal Dave Alvin, and I'd like to play a song by my favorite honky-tonk singer, Wynn Stewart. Now for those of you who've never heard of Wynn Stewart, Wynn was one of the architects of the West Coast country sound back in the 1950s. He had a band that included the great Ralph Mooney on pedal steel, the astounding Roy Nichols on electric lead guitar, and he occasionally had a bass player named Merle Haggard. So if you don't believe me, just go ask Merle. All right, now I'd like to play this video of Wynn Stewart being backed up by Buck Owens' Buckaroos doing his beautiful song, Wishful Thinking. And if we were in a honky-tonk right now, I'd be playing this on the jukebox.
My heart echoes the love words you've spoken. How I wish I could hear them from you. Won't you answer this heart that's broken and make my wishful thinking come true?
All right, welcome back to the show, folks. And now the moment you've been waiting for, our good friend, Sonny Leyland, with his tribute to Moon Mulligan.
And the fellow from way down Texas way, we're awful proud to have Mr. Moon Mulligan.
Well, way down yonder in a great big lake, sitting on a lily pad, well, a big bullfrog about 2 feet long, and they called him old granddad. When he raised his right foot in the air, and his children gather around, we gonna rock and roll tonight before the moon goes down.
Hillbilly pianist Moon Mulligan came into this world in 1909. 111 years later, his legacy lives on, but sadly without the fame and fortune he deserves.
Here's the story of how and why this landmark album, Will the Circle Be Unbroken, came to be.
I was a teenage banjo player,
and I just started a new group, Nitty Gritty Dirt Band, and it was 1966.
Mighty fine and a great big western howdy. This is Ranger Doug with Riders in the Sky. The singing cowboy is an icon in America, with names like Roy Rogers, Gene Autry, and Tex Ritter the most recognizable. This bunch has become famous through their movies and television shows, but before they came along, there was the original singing cowboy. The notion of the singing cowboy was established way back in 1925, when Carl T. Sprague from Texas recorded the first cowboy song, When the Work's All Done This Fall.
You know, Christopher's been working very hard on this fantastic tribute to his old friend Manuel, and my old friend too, the rhinestone Rembrandt. So here he is, the great Manuel.
Silver threads and golden needles cannot bend this heart of mine, and I dare not drown my sorrow in the warm glow of your wine. You can't buy my love with money, 'cause I never was that kind. Silver threads and golden needles cannot bend.
Billy Joe Shaver is the inspiration for this eclectic American roots series that we call Honky Tonk Heroes, because that is exactly who Billy Joe was. Since the age of 12, he spent most of his life in honky tonks and made a name for himself through his songwriting and his irrepressible personality. Billy Joe Shaver was a bona fide, certified Lone Star original, a throwback to a far different time. It was echoed in the music he wrote and performed over a very adventurous life. He died in 2020 at age 81, but left a body of work that will inspire songwriters for ages to come. Willie Nelson called Shaver the greatest living songwriter, and Johnny Cash called him my favorite songwriter. His songs were recorded by Elvis Presley, Willie Nelson, David Allan Coe, Johnny Cash, and Waylon Jennings, among many others. Shaver's own debut album, Old Five and Dimers, was produced by Christofferson in 1973. Shaver's career is the stuff of legends. As a young man, he had been thumbing west to California, but couldn't get a ride, so he simply crossed the road and headed east, ending up in Nashville instead. He got a job writing songs for $50 a week, but it wasn't until Waylon Jennings heard one at a Willie Nelson picnic that his work really caught fire. Jennings recorded the first Outlaw album in 1973, and he titled it Honky Tonk Heroes, using nearly all Shaver's songs on that album. I'm proud to say that we had Billy Joe and his band perform at the legendary Don the Beachcomber. Arriving late with his band all ready to go, Shaver clambered up onto the tiki stage and observed, "It's like a jungle in here." A few years later, Shaver headlined the Long Beach Folk Festival. As the MC, I was getting ready to introduce his appearance when word came he was in the emergency room, having fallen flat on his face after the sound check. We altered the lineup so he could perform last, and just before his show, he came limping up to me, his face all skinned up and still dripping blood. I asked if he could still perform, and he gave me that big old Texas smile and said, "Why not?" He took the stage that night, still dripping blood off his face, onto the mic, and all over his denim shirt. His performance was typical Shaver. He never missed a beat and played the entire set without stopping.
And I just thought I'd mention, my grandma's old age pension is the reason why I'm standing here today. I got all my country learning, milking and a churning, digging cotton, raising, hailing, baling hay. I've been to Georgia on a fast train, honey, I wasn't born no yesterday. Got a good Christian raising and an 8th grade education. Ain't no needin' y'all are treating me this way.
Here is another clip of Big Sandy doing the Lord's work for all you vintage roots fans out there.
Howdy, my friends. Big Sandy here, excited to share this week's video treasures as we explore the roots of Tex-Mex music. Let's take a look at Steve Jordan playing with Corpus Christi bandleader Isidro López.
Como si andaras conmigo, tienes marcada la vida.
como si andara contigo. Quieren que yo me despida. Ay, corazón traicionero, me vas a comprometer. Antes me harán prisionero que dejarte de querer.
This is a good one today, isn't it? Old, something new, something borrowed, all things blue.
About how many hours go into putting together every 2-hour weekly show?
It's become a full-time job. So, I mean, 30, 40 hours each week. Seriously, even just for my little part that I do, which I really enjoy doing, but I quit each week. But because you end up doing, you know, writing, producing, editing, like with my parts, it's like a self-contained thing. So I end up doing what a team of people would do. So
that, well, if you don't count the planning time and don't count contacting musicians all over the world, then we might be down under 200 hours collectively between all the time that Big Sandy puts in. You may not realize this, but a lot of those video clips he does have been reprogrammed. He'll take a soundtrack from one and a clip from another and marry them together just to get the best quality for you. It's amazing what this guy does. And then of course we have the pre-production and the post-production, and depending on what kind of show it is, it could be well over 200 hours just to create a 2-hour program.
Place. It's a place that supports the kind of music that I do and that you're probably into. Stellar Shows production.
Enjoy another clip from a show that we call Honky Tonk Heroes.
Well, 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 Mark Christian here, singer, songwriter, and guitarist with the band Merle Jagger. And I would just love for you to check out one of my favorite honky tonk Ameripolitan artists, Johnny Falstaff from Houston, Texas. Let's hear a track from Johnny's new record right now called Stars.
Put on your traveling shoes, I'm taking you to the stars. Me and you are one, true love can be ours.
going back to the early shows, the first one we pulled off was Western Swing. We did a 2.5 hour compilation of people, including Dale Watson and Celine. We did a tribute to Asleep at the Wheel. It was a lot of fun, and it showed us what we had the potential to do. And from there, we springboarded to a lot of other shows that are a lot of fun. We actually did a whole series on the tiki music and culture, three separate volumes of tiki music and culture, including surf music and Martin Denny and the whole Polynesian culture. So we're getting into a lot of different kinds of roots. It's a lot of fun to get into. And wait till you see what we've got coming up in the future.
Oh, boy. Sandy, do you have any favorites?
Well,
aside from when you're hamming it up on the stage.
Well, each time I go back and look at these shows, there are little parts of it because you get lost in it while you're doing it. When you go back and look later, it's like, wow, I forgot. There's some beautiful things in each episode. I think, man, it's a tough one, but I think maybe the Tex-Mex episode, because I put a little extra into that. There's a family connection with the music. And I ended up feeling very, really proud of that one. So maybe that's one of the standouts, if not the one that's on the top of the list for me.
The group's infectious, party-ready sound blended country, early rock and roll, Mexican folk, rhythm and blues, and whatever other roots music crossed their paths. But everybody just calls it Tex-Mex.
If you got the dinero, oh, I got my Camaro. Just flash some cash, we'll buy some gas, off we'll go. Bring all of your pesos, I supply all the bases. Go and buy some cerveza, ride up the mesa, watch the sun go down.
What can people do to help spread the word and keep this music going?
I think it's important to remember that a lot of our shows are archived on YouTube. Dozens of our shows are there at a click of your finger. You can watch them on your phone. You can watch them on a big screen TV. You just go to the Stellar Jax channel on YouTube and knock yourself out. There's a lot of great material there to watch.
And when you do go to YouTube, we want to make sure we get people to subscribe to the channel, because there'll be more and more of these shows. And hit the bell so that you get the notifications when the new shows come up.
Yeah. And hit that share button. That's what it's there for, folks. And if enough people share the show and it gets around even more, they'll have the Beatles on for you. As long as they stick to the rootsy side of stuff. There's still new things to be said all the time. And spreading, helping to spread them and keeping the music alive and vital and all that. And that seems to be a big component of your show.
One thing that defines roots music, as much as anything can define something so generic, yeah, is its foundation in the past, even as it reaches into the future with evolving sounds and different subjects.
Yeah.
So roots music is as brand new as you want it to be and as ancient and vintage as you wish it to be as well.
What's your take on roots and where they're going?
Well, I think that was, I guess it took a while to come to a certain realization that it's not about focusing on specific elements, but by trying to capture the spirit of these things that from the past that we enjoy, and not try to imitate it, but celebrate it. And I think that comes through with music I've been able to make over the years, and we're hoping that shines through on these shows as well.
There are not many people that are doing discrete broadcast mixes and the kind of production values that we have at Stellar Jax. And again, we have Tim Ellis to thank for that. Something else to keep in mind is our shows are free. They're donation-based. You can watch without paying a nickel if you wish, or you can help the artists out, help them pay their grocery bills, their car payments, and their mortgages, because they're people that are totally out of work for the longest period of time. And that's why we do these shows. We need your donations to help our musicians get by during this damn panic.
Hey, everybody, this is Eddie Clendenning saying howdy to you here. stellar shows at JAX and Eclectic American Roots. Me and all my friends to talk about Sam Phillips and Sun Records, play a little music, have a chat, talk quarantine and all things rock and roll.
For you, what sort of response are you getting from the people that are watching this every week?
Well, I've been blown away by the response that I've been getting and that the show has been getting as a whole. For me, I've been approaching the show the same way that I would a performance or a recording. And it's different for each show. When we've done the, there was two jazz episodes, jazz trumpet and jazz saxophone. I tried to approach the way I put piece together the videos in a way that like a jazz solo would go. And I tried to, you know, riff off of certain themes. That's how I was thinking. That's the thought that went into it. And hopefully the feeling came across. Whereas the Hillbilly episode, I tried to have a little more lighthearted feel to that country. There's some of it was a little more solemn, but also with the humor. But each show is approached in a different way for me. So there's a certain, for me, you try to put a bit of your art into it. And I think people, whether they pick up on something, even if they don't realize that's what's gone into it. And the response has been really, really nice. Almost to the level of actually performing. It's near that. Mm-hmm.
And I've been blessed to find out that there's a lot of people out there that love the same kind of music that I love. And when we say roots, it's a pretty wide set of roots and branches, but it includes things like rhythm and blues. It includes things like folk, Americana, country rock, rockabilly, jazz. It's a wide world that a lot of people are not covering. And that's why I'm so proud of what Eclectic American Roots is doing. We are covering the world. You know, it's fun to watch the shows as they happen and make comments in the margins when we're watching on Facebook at stellar shows and concerts. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the same people come on the show and a lot of new faces come on the show. And we make sure they all feel welcome and mm-hmm. they want to come back again. And sure enough, they do.
Christopher, when concerts do come roaring back finally, and you're busy enough doing that, do you think you'll still find time to see the importance of doing this as well?
It all depends on our audience. If they continue to be loyal and want to see our Sunday matinees, we'll keep doing these shows. It's nice that we've archived enough of them that we can occasionally do a rerun. Mm-hmm. But one of the things I'm most proud of is that people compare our show to the History Channel. A lot of them say, it's like a musical history channel. And I say, thank you. Our goal is to become more like an Austin City Limits. I think that's where we're going. We want to continue to create this festival atmosphere. So when people are watching our show, no matter where in the world, they're online with all these other folks that are like-minded, enjoying the music like they are, and just having a blast.
Big Sandy, once you're out there on the road again, and do you still see being able to do this? And if so, what will keep you doing it?
Well, we'll have less time to do it when I'm back out on the road. But I want to carve out some time to continue to do a bit of this and maybe think of a way that I can combine the things. I might be able to do some reports from the road that get folded back into the show. I think there's a lot of different opportunities that might lie ahead. And just looking forward to that. But I don't want to let this go.
Here's another cool set of vintage clips from video host Big Sandy.
Big Sandy back again for round number three of today's video treasures. This time we're going to take a look at Mississippi-born Chicago blues great Hubert Sumlin. You bet.
Puffin' and it sure looks fine. Rockin' and a rollin' on down the line. They call me a hobo, but I don't mind. I'm as happy
happy as a bumblebee, rockin' and a rollin' towards Tennessee.
Thank you for stopping by, and we'll see you next time on Eclectic American Roots. I'm Big Sandy. Thank you.
Hey, everybody. It's Rosie Flores. Just reminding you, don't forget to tune in to Eclectic American Roots show this Sunday. It's going to be a great one.
What first got you into this music? Was it something coming out of the radio or the TV, or what is it that hit you over the head as a kid or whenever that made you say, well, here, I'm stuck with this for the rest of my life?
In my case, it was 1976. Yeah. It was the bicentennial, and we put on a program called the Bicentennial. It had a buffalo theme. Uh-huh. And we worked in bluegrass and honky tonk and western swing bands. Mm-hmm. And after that, I was hooked.
Okay. And Sandy?
I just grew up in a household full of music. But my parents are music lovers, record collectors. There was great music on the radio still at that time. Great oldies radio. Coming of age in the 70s, it was a decade of nostalgia, you know, with American Graffiti and everything that followed after that. And I just couldn't wait to be a teenager and listen to that doo-wop music and have a girlfriend cruising in their hot rod. And those, all of those ideas swirled around music. And eventually I found that I was able to do some of that music myself, and then fell into the rockabilly scene in Southern California. And that kind of solidified a lot of the ideas that I already had growing up, and it became a thing for me. And yeah, I just fell in, started playing that music myself.
Okay. So basically it was all about the chicks.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you, Min, for taking this time to tell us more about this great place hiding on the internet now that is becoming more of a less of a secret every week, I hope, because it sure is fabulous. And for everyone out there watching, don't forget, it's called Eclectic American Roots. Every Sunday coming your way, that's noon Pacific time.
Thanks for watching, everybody. I am proud to say Stellar Shows and Stellar Jax have paid out close to $1 million over the past decade to roots music artists of all kinds through our live show and through our streaming shows. We hope you take this occasion to share our programs today among your friends. Anywhere people like really good American roots music. See all our past music shows on YouTube at the Stellar Jax channel. And remember, every Sunday at noon Pacific time, you have a date with Eclectic American Roots.